We live in a rapidly changing world, a world that is becoming more environmentally conscious. The world is moving to safeguard the environment by shifting to lower emissions for our energy needs. New technologies are being developed, which drive major growth in renewable energy, energy efficiency, and global connectivity for a sustainable future. New industries are emerging to support this major shift in the world. New technologies and ways of producing energy lead to a growing demand in critical minerals to support these industries. This is driving change in the metals which the world will use in the future. Rare earth metals are a group of specialty metals that are essential as our planet moves to develop clean energy technology. They drive the technologies that convert motion to electricity and electricity to motion. Rare earths are critical materials for new industries that will transition the world toward increasing environmental sustainability. Kvanefjeld in southern Greenland is one of the largest and advanced rare earth projects globally. For over 12 years, Greenland Minerals has been extensively researching and studying Kvanefjeld and the surrounding environment to see how the resource can be efficiently extracted with maximum benefit to the community and minimal impact on the environment. Kvanefjeld is now ready to progress towards development at an ideal time, with rare earth demand forecast to grow significantly through the coming decades. The project is located in a unique area called the Ilimausak intrusion. Unusual rocks enriched with rare materials are found all over the area. For thousands of years, these rocks have been exposed by natural weathering and have been shed and broken down into the valleys, rivers, and fjords. They can easily be seen along the slopes of the fjords, where rocks with elevated rare earths naturally break down, forming the beaches that line the shores of the local fjords. The rocks that will be mined are called ore and are high in rare earths, but also contain some zinc and uranium. The ore has been dispersed within the local environment for thousands of years, creating an area naturally enriched in rare elements. The local community has been living near these rocks for many centuries without any issues. To ensure minimal impact on the environment, and importantly, the safety and well-being of the community, the Kvanefjeld project has been meticulously planned, with input from Greenlandic stakeholders, communities, consultants, and extensive scientific research. The results of the impact studies have been reviewed by the Danish Centre for the Environment, Canadian government authorities, and consultants. Rare earths occur in special minerals that only make up a small amount of the overall ore. The ore is mined from the ground and is then processed with the option of two scenarios. The first scenario involves crushing and concentrating the rare earths minerals in Greenland to produce a final product of rare earth mineral concentrate with a by-production of zinc concentrate and fluorspar to be shipped to international markets. Rare earth minerals make up 5% of the ore, with the remaining 95% of the ore stored in tailings. The second scenario involves the crushing, concentrating, and the additional step of chemical processing in Greenland. The process involves chemical treatment of rare earth minerals to recover a higher value rare earths products and uranium as a byproduct. The chemical process tailings are stored in a separate, smaller tailings dam. The extent of processing in Greenland will be determined in close consultation with Greenlandic stakeholders. The tailings consist of a fine silt, which is similar in composition to the silt in the Narsaq River. It is safely stored in a large natural basin near the processing plant. Water for the project is supplied by a special dam, which only uses about 10% of the total flow of the Narsaq River. The products of the processing plant are trucked to the port location via an access road. The products are loaded onto ships, where they are carried to international markets. Located to the south of the process plant site is a natural, large basin shaped like a shallow bowl called Tasik. The water in Tasik has naturally elevated levels of fluoride and supports no forms of aquatic life. There is no competing land use, and the slopes of the basin are almost free of vegetation. It is a great location to store tailings. The bottom of Tasik is made up of solid, impenetrable rock which will be double-lined to prevent leakage. Dam walls will be constructed from solid rocks with shallow wall angles. They are designed so that they will never overflow. In the northwest corner, a smaller dam will also be constructed to safely store the chemical residue, which will contain the unrecovered thorium if a refinery is included in the project. The dam walls are specifically designed for Greenlandic conditions. They will remain stable under extreme natural conditions, including earthquakes and flooding. The company will ensure that tailings produced by the project are permanently stored in a facility that is constructed to the world's best standards. This will allow for thousands of years of safe and stable storage. Like other rare earth mines, Kvanefjeld ore is weakly radioactive due to the presence of uranium and thorium. Weather conditions have already dispersed uranium and thorium into the surrounding environment, including Narsaq Valley and local fjords. This naturally contributes to the elevated levels of natural background radiation in the project area. The radiation exposure for the local community is higher than normal globally, yet still comfortably within safe conditions. Radiation occurs naturally all over our planet, and we are all exposed to it in our everyday lives. It can be through soil, food, radio waves, or activity. Greenland Minerals hired independent and world-class consultants to investigate the radiation impact on people and the environment from developing the Kvanefjeld project. The investigation looked at all possible pathways of increasing radiation exposure related to project activities, both short-term and long-term. This includes radiation exposure from eating food, drinking water, and walking near the mine area. The results show radiation exposure will increase by less than 2% compared to normal once the project is developed. Combined with the background radiation exposure, the local community will be safe. Thorium is a naturally occurring radioactive element like uranium, but is four times less radioactive. It is also enriched in the Kvanefjeld ore in the same minerals as the rare earths. As a result, the main tailings for the project will have less thorium than the ore and similar levels to those measured in silt of the Narsaq River. If rare earth minerals are processed in Greenland, the thorium content of this small tailings dam will be elevated, but will be present in a stable form that does not pose risk to people or the environment. Scientists are currently investigating the feasibility of producing low emissions electricity from thorium. However, today there is no commercial market for thorium, so it will be stored in a stable form in the tailings facilities for possible treatment by future Greenland generations. Due to the nature of mining, a number of activities for the project will produce dust. The company will adopt several measures to keep dust levels to a minimal. These include dust containment devices, which will be used with equipment in dusting area, and in areas prone to dusting, water sprays will be used to limit the extent to which dust becomes airborne. World experts in predicting the impacts of dust from mining were used to map the possible spread of dust. Best available techniques were used to forecast the impact of the dust, with results of the modelling verified by the Danish Centre for Environment and Canadian government specialists. The results show the dust emissions will be contained in the mine area only. Areas outside of the mine will receive very low levels of additional dust, which are well below Greenlandic or other relevant international standards. In the long term, it shows that additional dust near the town or farming areas will be insignificant, and in the event of a severe Fian wind, dust will only fall near the mine area. Sheep, cattle and reindeer farming can continue to operate as normal, with no harmful effects from the Kvanefjeld project. Mining near agricultural areas is commonly practiced in other countries, such as Australia and Canada. Fluoride is a soluble salt. Many of the rocks in and around the project area are naturally elevated in fluoride. Fluoride is added to drinking water in many countries across the world to improve the health of teeth. However, fluoride at high levels is not safe to drink. Due to the natural water flow of water off these rocks, the fluoride level in the local rivers and Narsaq drinking water are naturally elevated and has been the case for many thousands of years. The project recycles as much water as possible to reduce water consumption. The recycled water is treated to remove fluoride and produce a product called Fluispar. Fluispar is sold as an additional byproduct while also removing fluoride from the project area. The tailings facilities will contain water, which is high in fluoride, during the operations phase only. Every possible way for this water to escape has been modelled and evaluated by independent scientists to see if fluoride contamination is possible. The results show that the environment is not harmed, even under extreme conditions. The Narsaq water supply is located to the north of the town. Water flows off a high mountain ridge into a small river which flows into the water supply facility. The Kvanefjeld tailings dam is located away to the north of the water catchment for the town water supply. The flow of water from the basin is down the Tasik River and connecting with the Narsaq River. There is no direct connection between the tailings facilities and the drinking water catchment. Expert consultants have evaluated possible risks for the drinking water. The amount of dust falling in the drinking water catchment is very low. Therefore, the possibility of metals leaching from the dust into the drinking water will be very small, with no impact to the health of the community, as the impact will be well below the government guideline health limits. The risk of dust on drinking water catchment area is not a threat to the livelihood of people or livestock, such as cattle, reindeer, or sheep. The possibility of Fian winds blowing mist from the tailings dam into the water catchment was also evaluated. This included multiple strong Fian windstorms each year. The evaluation shows that mist spray contamination of the drinking water will not make the drinking water unhealthy. The same large mountain range which provides the drinking water for Narsaq also protects it from possible project contamination. The use of hydroelectric power has been studied as a viable option to power the project. Elevated lakes located to the north of the project area are suitable for significant new hydropower capacity. This provides the project with a sustainable energy source to produce green critical minerals. This reduces the greenhouse gas emission during the production of rare earths to a minimum, while providing an opportunity for the local community to receive additional hydroelectrical power supply from the project. This is one of many development options available to give the project flexibility. The Kvanefjeld project will result in many benefits for the local community and for the broader Greenland. The footprint of the project aims to have a minimal impact to everyday life where possible. There is expected to be little or no impact on fishing, hunting or recreational activities. The project will seek to acquire local produce from the valley area to encourage the continuation of traditional activities. Job opportunities will be available for Greenlanders, with preference for residents in Narsaq. The company has employed and worked with local residents during previous drilling and field seasons. In the future, the project will offer many more job and training programs. As there are many years of life to the mine, this will mean decades of employment, which will attract a younger generation back to the community. This will provide generations with meaningful employment and skills, which can be applied to more than just mining. There will be benefits for local companies and businesses selling goods and services to the mining company. The company will pay taxes to both the local municipality and the government of Greenland. It will be one of the largest taxpayers in Greenland, which will in turn benefit the community with more funding towards better services and welfare. The move to a better environment inevitably means more rare earth mining will be required. Other countries are moving with confidence to develop their rare earth mines as they are critical minerals. These other rare earth projects are similar to Kvanefjeld in many ways. They consist of the same process steps: mine, concentration, refinery and tailings dam. However, Kvanefjeld is flexible as to how it is developed to meet the local stakeholders' preferences. They are in locations which are surrounded by farms and tourist destinations. They, like Kvanefjeld, have been shown to have no material environmental impact on both of these industries. Like Kvanefjeld, these mining projects also contain rare metals, including radioactive rocks. However, the radiation impact has been independently assessed to be low. These projects offer skilled long-term jobs for many decades to come, prosperity and benefits flowing to the local community. Projects like Kvanefjeld can be developed while respecting the environment and local stakeholders. Green minerals, green future, Greenland.